Wala. Wala deo, guys. Wala deo. Seriously, there is a Ghanaian lady trending on TikTok right now that Davido is the father of her baby. First saw that post on Instagram by a Nigerian blogger on Instagram. He's not one of those credible blogger that I know that was okay, oh, we can bank on her news, we can be okay with what we get there, is after all is the truth. No, she no follow. She's on those probably type of blog. So I didn't take it serious. But I said, let me go on TikTok to have my usual fun, like post my videos and my kids, just to my usual. I'm seeing a lot of videos, I mean, trending on TikTok. This lady is trending. Her name is, wait, where's my phone? So the lady is on TikTok trending and she's claiming that Davido is the father of her baby. Waiting they happen. Hey, what is going on? Chale, what is going on? Hey, so because me, I don't want to get any copyright claim, any copyright strike on my video. What I would do, I'm going to put the picture. I'm going to screenshot and put the picture on this video. Guys, this lady and the baby looks exactly like Davido. The baby looks exactly like Davido. And this lady Minito, she have been, you know, making, I'm going to put everything on the screen so that you guys can see. The first post got her, like, the first video is at almost 500,000 views. A lot of people have seen that video. The second one is that 500,000, 641,000 views on TikTok. And then the last one that she made today, that one is at 12K views on TikTok. A lot of people are reacting to it. A lot of people are asking her question, and she's saying Davido is the father of her baby. In as much as I want to feel like she's just catching cruise, I feel like I need a reason not to believe her. I mean, I need one good reason not to believe her, but I can't see that reason, because man, look at it. I'm going to insert it on the screen so that you guys can see. The baby looks a lot like Harley Adeleke, baby Davido's second baby, the one he had with the American lady. Ah, they look alike. The baby looks a lot like Davido. No difference. Oh my, such a cute baby. But how true is this? Who is going to help us verify? Ha! Is it that Jesus lover? I've not seen this. The lady is going on and on. I don't like this kind of confidence. You will not have this kind of confidence to call someone out like this. Like this lady is doing. Look at her. Look at her. Look at her. Look at the videos. I don't think you have the morale, the guts to put your baby and the videos and be telling the whole world that David is the father of your baby. It's getting crazy. Now, we are going to talk about a lot of things. In this video, I'm also going to talk about why I don't want a relationship with my dad at all. I don't want anything from my father. He shouldn't get anything from me. I don't care. I don't care. You get it, about my dad. I'm going to talk about it in this video. But before we get to that part, I want us to just take a look at what is happening with David. I mean, I don't get it. The American lady, I know where she's driving at. The American lady, a lot of people are speculating that, oh, she have gone to have an abortion. She don't want to keep the baby. Hey, a lot of people are saying she wants to abort the baby. But my dear, I'm here to tell you that girl is not aborting any baby. She's keeping that baby. She just wants to mentally torture the widow. And I've seen cases like that. I've seen people do that, you know, in a case where things end up like this, where the mother and father are not in good terms, the father is angry, you know, to the point that they try to frame the mother. They try to call her a prostitute. You get it? And then she fighting back, she getting so angry, discovering more things that the guy is married and never told her. According to her, so she didn't know that Davido was married. She didn't know that Davido is married. So she didn't know a lot of things. In fact, there, if they see each other, they may get physical. The lady, from all the way she display on social media, shows that if she sees Davido, she'll get physical with him. I can see that anger. I feel like she wants to mentally torture him. What she wants to do is, she already told the video fans that she wants to get rid of the baby. She's not going to keep the baby. She hates children. Ah, lie. Okay? That girl is going to keep that baby. She just wants to torture David. Now, this is someone you're not in good terms with. You can't reach out to her to ask her how is the baby. And this is an independent lady, a lady with lots of money of her own. She won't be needing your money to survive, to take care of the baby. So she don't really have any reason to come close to you, but you just be there, the whole thing will bother you, but you don't know what to say, you can't go close. You wish to know if the baby is there or not, but you can't go close. She's not aborting any baby. All this one she's saying is just to remove people's minds. I don't know why sometimes we Nigerians, we are easily fooled, by people on social media. Don't let anybody fool you. We are easily fooled by people on social media. Just, they want to get you off their back. They just tell you, oh yeah, throw stone to this place. Oh yeah, so you will follow it while the real truth is here. Anita is not about to abort that baby. Anita just want to deal with Davido. She's not done dealing with him. Who am I to tell her when to be done or not to? You know, however she wants to deal with her issues is her life. But I just want us to know that, see that baby, she's not about to abort that baby. Just want to torture Davido mentally. As for the French girl, that one, for me, I don't know why, but I feel like she's not pregnant. All right, there's a lot of misunderstanding going on, especially on YouTube. I have been following both of them just so that I will know, until Aproko now, until I'm a born to gossip, you know, just to know what's going on. I don't know why I feel like that French girl is not pregnant. See, there's a confidence you have when you're calling someone out that you're pregnant. There's a confidence, she doesn't have it. One day she's in the good, she wants to be a good friend. The second day she wants to be an enemy. And she constantly announced on Instagram that she's pregnant, pregnant, pregnant. See, people with money don't want to talk about money, money, money. People that are beautiful won't always be saying, I'm beautiful, I'm beautiful, I'm beautiful. Intelligent people wouldn't be saying, I'm intelligent, I'm very, very intelligent. I mean, a pregnant woman wouldn't be coming out to always say, hey, I'm pregnant in the morning, I'm pregnant in the afternoon. So this is why I strongly believe she may not be pregnant. And even if she is, maybe not for the video. I don't know, but I feel like that French girl is not pregnant. But in case she is, who am I? It's her own problem, her cup of tea. I wish her all the best. Now, let's talk about Imade, Davido's first baby, and why I don't want a relationship with my dad. Now, Davido and Imade is the first baby Davido had before every other child that he has now and the ones he'll be having now. Imade is 8 years old, by the way, right now. 8 years old, already knows a lot of things, already is aware of, as an 8 years old child, you're aware of a lot of things. You're aware of the people in your life, your mother, your father, your uncle, your grandpa, your siblings, if you have any, your aunties, your mom's close friends. You know people around you. You understand your environment very well. So Imade is 8 years already, and David had recently cut her off completely. No going close to her, no wishing her birthdays, happy birthday like he used to wish, not flaunting her like he used to flaunt, not doing anything, basically just not, in fact, talking about her or just going close to her. And the mother came out to call him out on social media that he has not been taking responsibility, he has not been supporting the baby financially, he has not been supporting her to take care of the baby for Imade financially. Even though we Nigerians try to silence her, Nigerians on social media silence her, go, don't stop complaining, you are jealous, go and make your own money, stop complaining, it's because the guy didn't marry you, he ended up marrying another woman that he loves, go look for your own. You know, we forgot the men thing on the table. They don't want her, they have silenced her, and she have gone back into her shell. just calm, like nothing happened. And it's not like there have been any adjustment that Davido have made to Soke O. So that kind of like to Soke O, because this lady have called me out, so I'm feeling bad, let me go back and continue my relationship with my baby Madeo. No, it's not like that. Instead, he's about to welcome more kids, including the ones he don't want to. He's welcoming them into the world. So why am I saying this? Is now Imade is already, have we, I don't know, sometimes I feel like people on social media, I don't know if it's the same set of human that I see every day out here. I feel like people on social media don't have sympathy at all, especially on Instagram and Twitter. Now, this is a child who have been growing up with her dad, knowing her father, having a relationship with her dad, then all of a sudden, her dad have caught her off completely. How do you think that child will feel? That child is going to be traumatized. Imade is traumatized. And this is why I don't want a relationship with my dad. I feel like, what is the point? In my case, I remember as a child in my village, living with my grandmom and my mom. Back then, early in the morning, there used to be these women in our village that sells food, rice. Because I come from that tropical African village. I come from a village, a very local place, to get it. Now, there used to be these women that sells rice on their head in the morning. They'll carry, Ilahi, buy rice, you know, they sell all that, fry. That is not something I used to eat every night when I'm going to sleep, because I come from that kind of village, a very local one. We don't get to eat rice all the time. Rice is luxury to a lot of families. So my mom don't used to give us that to eat. There was a day my dad was buying rice for other of his children, the one that he loves, the one that he stays with, the one that the new wife has for him. And that same woman that threatened him that if he has a relationship, if he nears me, she's done with him. I remember there was a day he was buying rice for his children. And me, because the rice seller passed our house. So she already passed before I went in to bring the money I have made from job. There's this thing we used to go help some farmers to transplant their rice. I mean, we used to go and this rice nursery, this most more this rice seedlings, this rice seedlings, we used to go and help them during that transplanting of rice period. So we kids in the village, we used to make a lot of money, like small money, to buy granola, buy this. So the money that I have made, and I wanted to use it to buy rice. So by the time I come out, the woman have already gone to the other compound, down towards my dad's compound. So I came out from the room with my plates. I had to chase the woman. So me and my father jammed each other. Already, I didn't see him to be anything for me, but people have always gossiped that is my dad. I remember the rice seller selling my rice for me. After selling for me, she asked my dad that should she collect money from me or from him. Trust me, I don't know what he said. For me, I remember giving the rice seller the money, you know, paying her money and walking away because I was quite young. But I remember that. All right. So this is someone I watch him buy food for his other children. So why should I have anything to do with him? I don't need him in my life. Okay. I don't need my father. And besides, I feel like going back to having a relationship with my dad would be like me encouraging bad behavior. Because right now I'm dealing with that, like single-handedly being responsible for my two kids. When these people are alive, I mean, I'm doing this all alone. My little baby that I have wished, like above all things, that she have a relationship with her dad so that she gets to not miss anything in her life. Like what I have missed, that fatherly love, you know, I just want it for her, but her dad is not available it's very unavailable because another person's mother, a single mom like me somewhere, have told him is the condition for the relationship. If he nears Wendy and she gets to see, they are done. So my baby don't have a relationship with her dad. And now, this is the exact thing that my dad did to me. So if I am anything to my father, it simply means I'm encouraging bad behavior. Because I know what my mom went through, may have gone through that time. To get it, I can imagine what my mom have gone through, and she can't speak up because they will condemn her. They will tell her, hey, if you're speaking up, because she speak up, they are going to say she's in love with the man. If she complains about anything, if she just, I wonder how she felt watching this man riding a motorcycle with his other kids, not acknowledging me. I wonder how she felt each time this man walks past her, each time they walk past each other and he never asks her about me. I wonder how she feels during Christmas period when other kids get their Christmas dresses from their father, or their father gives their mother's money to go shopping for them. I wonder how my mom felt doing it all by herself, having to work, save that money, having to sell a lot of things from her farm to go buy me the dress to make me feel special. And then only for me to grow up, and then this man just came from nowhere and say he wants a relationship. Like, I don't get it. So this is why I can't. My dad means nothing to me. As a matter of fact, it means absolutely nothing to me. It's just like any other human being. If I want to be kind to my father, it's not because he's special. I just want to do it because I like to. I enjoy giving, even though I don't do it on camera. Yeah, I love giving. It's something I love. I love it so much. I can't help myself. I love it. I don't have any regret. But you see, when it comes to giving to him, because he's my father, I'm not part of it. All right? So, seriously, if you want to abandon your children now, think about the consequences in future, because it's not everyone that will just be okay forgiving you and just taking you back. And besides, it's not everyone that wants to take you back, okay? Because sometimes people believe that if everything is okay with you, you may not want to come back to reunite with them. I strongly believe my dad wanted to reunite with me because he fall out of love with his wife. They got divorced. Everybody went their separate ways, and a lot of evil things have been happening to them. Their kids have been dying, the kids they had together, a lot of things have been happening between them. So I feel like if all was smooth and nice, he would not have remembered me. You see? So why should I bother about such person? So whatever we do today, we should think about the consequences tomorrow. I am done in this video. I will see you another time. Bye.